Alright, what's up everybody? Hello. Let's get going here. We'll turn that off. We don't need that. Hey, what's up, Potato? Right, so here we are. It's been a while. But we on the OG here. We on the 55 million Xbox. The Hollywood Xbox. The one and only. The OG. Alright, this was something that I was going to do earlier in the week, but getting this set up is a bit of a hassle, and it was also a hassle because it took me 45 minutes to find the fucking cable that you need to do this. Said cable is now over £60 on eBay, pre-owned. Anybody that's got the original Elgato, like the first one they did, the one that was 30fps, there was a cable that came with that that allows you to hook up a component to it. As I recall, they stopped including that cable when they went to, 60fps HDMI only ones, as of the 60, essentially. That cable, evidently, is extremely hard to find now. I was thinking it was going to be, maybe like 20 quid or something on eBay, because I was just going to buy a new one, honestly, but when I saw how much they were, I thought, right, fuck it. We're going all out here, it's time to unpack everything and find this goddamn cable. Thankfully, I did find it. And I also think I have, by complete fluke, a second one from an old DVD recorder I used to have. And for those of you, that just went, what the hell's a DVD recorder? Well, yeah, there you go. That shows you how old it is. We're going to try and beat my... because I got 778 on this while going for the back-to-back 700K on, the Xbox One. That is actually higher than my original score. My original score is 750 on here. So it's only, 28K or something, but... that's 28K, man. Oh shit, yeah. Okay, that's dead. Alright. Yeah, this is not gonna be easy to beat. 778 on this mission is pretty good. So I did take the liberty. Yeah, so you see it, 754, so it's only 24k. But that 24k, looking at my mission mode, that will give me 55.2 million. So we want those points. You can probably hear the Xbox, it's quite loud. But yeah, on my run, I had 25k in-game karma, she's dead at 215, I have half life, and I have the Black Cat Fiend, both Crab Fiends, and one Laser Crab Fiend's UT'd Essence with Benediction. So, we're not necessarily guaranteed to get this today. Like, this is, that's a good run. To run. That's a very good run to go against. The good news is that on the original Xbox, her fireballs are slightly easier to dodge. that's good. Although that said, the muscle memory now is very much used to the Xbox One, so. That might trip us up. Man, you can actually, you can visibly see how much slower they are. Like, that's not just me, right? Like, you can see that. What's up, Valius, by the way? That's gonna be tricky, though. We'll just do this. Need to get a side-by-side. We need to get some side-by-side clips here. Because it's not just me. Like, that is noticeably slower. see, so far this runs okay, but like, look at my time. Like, I should be halfway through this already. Which we're not, and I need the, like, I need the cat fiends here, like, in a specific way. Which is not that. Not him. Nope. That was 100 seconds at the cat fiends as well, like, that's... That's no good. What's up, James? Yeah, I'm gonna try and make a point of doing that. It's gonna be hard to get, you know, an exact side-by-side, because it's gonna be tricky to get her in the exact same spot, but yeah. It's... Looking at that, that's not in our heads. Those fireballs move a lot quicker on the Xbox One. I blatantly rolled, but okay. Can kind of feel it a little, like, it's not terrible, but you can definitely feel it's not quite as snappy as the Xbox One. You can really feel it. Hey, what's up, Zonglin? How's it going? Are you up to any missions at the moment? Out of curiosity? You know, hint, hint. But if not, it's all good. But I know you said you were going to look at some of the other missions that don't have their high score on video. Yeah, I mean, look at that, man. Like, that was so much easier to dodge them. You son of a bitch. I was really hoping maybe the fireballs would have killed him, and then I could have got a cheeky UT. You can really feel the frame rate dip there. Like, when she does that big fireball, and I do a flying swallow into her. Like, you can really feel that. God damn it, Ryu. She's not gonna let me get that issue. Yeah. I'll take that. There was a lot of health. What's up, RJ? I lost a lot of health there, but... Feel that delay. Oh, that's bad. Oh, really? Time's getting up there as well. Oh my, wow, what a fucking hero. I mean, there's no way I can actually make this up, so. Yeah. And the odds of me killing the laser crabs at this health, like, pretty pretty slim. Especially with garbage like that. Oh well. Yeah, I'm on my original Xbox here. Yeah. I'm just going for, I'm going for above 778. That's all I want. And thankfully, I know, you know, having that on video, like, I know exactly what I need to beat that, which is, which does make it a lot less stressful. But yeah, I just want above 778, because that's actually more than my, my score on this is 751, I think. And it bugs me way more than it should, that my score is higher, like, on my, like, not original hardware. You know, I can't be dealing with that. Okay, not bad. I decided after much reading to not play NGS2, but rather play, not buy an Xbox 360 and NG2. Yeah, you could have got it on an S though. It would have ran a lot better. Or just an Xbox One, like Xbox, like it runs fine on Xbox One. Okay, nice. Feels so weird. Like, I'm having to delay that flying swallow input a little bit because I really feel like if I do it sort of on my like Xbox One muscle memory, I'm not gonna get it. That's annoying because I could have got an ET there. Of course you don't give me a yellow. I mean a blue. Depends what she does here, but. That's gonna disappear. Nope. Need the money. Need the money. These days I'm traveling in China. Oh, nice. All records I made, I use the Series X. Oh, nice. But yeah, so as long as you, like, this runs fine on. Yeah, so 754. So it's only 24K I need, you know? Oh, I also found my PlayStation Vita TV today. So that's good. That means hopefully I can look into that. You can purchase all games except... I really wish they would put NGO4 on... I really wish they would put NGO4 on... You know, the... Like, actually put that on the marketplace. It's a shame they don't. Why not use the Nunchuck? I'm not going for, like, the number one spot, man. I just want 778, and you can get that without farming her, so... Although she's kind of... Yeah, I mean, even this, like, this is kind of... Like, look at all this time she's burning here, you know? Like, that's not great. Nah, we're not bothering with that. 35 seconds? Fuck that. An Xbox One through online store or disc? Either. You can, if you've got a disc, you can put it in an Xbox One. NG2 runs significantly better on an Xbox. Like, NG2 on the 360, man, is pretty rough. I actually wouldn't recommend you play it on a 360. The performance is really bad on a 360. It really is. Like, and I would imagine there's not a lot in it in terms of picking one up, so... You know, if you can grab an Xbox One, you know, get one of them and play it that way. Don't kill both. Yeah, maybe. We'll see. That is worth more as a UT. So, of course, she fucking does that. I gotta just try it. Oh well. And also, just the usability of a 360 as well is kind of, you know... I mean, granted, the Xbox One's not that much better, but... you'll have a more pleasant experience just using I don't know if anyone's gone back and used a 360 lately. But man, the you forget how sluggish they are. Just in, you know, their operation, just little things like using the guide and all that stuff. They are extremely slow. Did I forget? I thought I forgot celerity there. That just seemed a little bit. All right. Let's see what she does. Okay. I didn't get this last time. Yeah, it's only worth 1,200. Like, that's really not a lot. But I mean, I guess that's 6k. Like, you know. Well, this is gone. We'll play it out. Yeah, 1,200 is what? That's only 6k endgame karma. So if you use that for a UT, you like that's literally worth double as a UT instead. So I'll just try for a knockdown. What's up, Skixis? Welcome. How we doing? Man, this is it's annoying how many good runs I got while going for this on that 700k thing. Like, how frequently I was getting, like, really solid CG1s was kind of annoying. Shit, that was my fault. Yeah, I know they are. I don't really know why. And after today, like, I really can't be asked to look into it. It just, like, the levels just completely changed on Friday. And yeah, I can't be bothered. So. Oh, thanks for the sub, Alice. I think using the sword to get her down is harder than the chucks. Really? I don't know about that. I feel like the sword is way easier. But that's maybe just that's just what I'm used to. Like, I've never farmed Awakened Alma. So. I mean, I suppose, you know, thinking about it, though, I could go for it. Because if I do get it, that's an ET. Man, I don't want that. God damn it. I really don't want that to kill both of them. I might try the Warhammer there, actually. Nice. Well, that's good. That is actually worth more, so. Oh, that's gonna be, there we go. What a bitch. I had celerity on for me. Oh, she wow, I can't believe she armored that. That was annoying. That was a good start. That was a really good start. I don't know. Does anybody know how, you know, in Digital Foundry do their, you know, their frame rate, their, like, live frame rate tracking? How do they do that? I'd be very interested to know what this runs at. Because I know it targets 60, but, like, this is definitely not holding 60. Like, right there. Like, every time she does the big fireball, and I do smoke bomb, like, and I do smoke bomb charge, like, that's a notice. Like, I can feel that drop. Oh, that would be... I was trying to leave that until the last minute, so hopefully, like, that fireball would have killed the imp. Oh, it disappeared anyway. That sucks. So did that. Thank you for that camera angle. Man, they are just so much easier to dodge. Oh, my... I wish that was consistent. Well, I mean, yeah, it's consistent in that it's inconsistent, but what I mean is I wish you could just windmill slash through her run. And it's annoying that you can't. It's really annoying that you can't do that. I don't know, maybe, I don't know. Is it? Is that just me being biased? I think you should be able to do that. Like, her, like, she should, that run that she does, that should be, you know, a committed, like, once she does that, like, she shouldn't be able to cancel it and just grab you like that. Like, that's mad cheap. Because, like, it's not, windmill slashing through that's not exactly something that, you know, a total new player is going to do. Like, that is definitely, you know, an advanced strategy. And the fact that you just get fucked for it is kind of shit. Yeah, see, I don't like this. Like, she's just wasting a bunch of time. Kill one of your minions. Or don't. I was gonna say, come on, mate. Chop, chop. He's got that 30 FPS run. What's it, dude? The most unfair boss in the game? Nah, that's Fiend Mirai, man. Fiend Mirai is way worse. He is way worse than Awakened Helm. Okay. This is not good. Oh my god, stop doing that. That's not better, though. I need the... Where the hell is the blue cat fiend? Oh my god. Oh, this is bad. That's gonna... Yeah, I knew it. I knew it. As soon as I launched her, I knew it. I was like, yep, I'm just gonna get juggled here. Yeah. Ugh, that's annoying. Oh well. Is the, I just noticed, actually, the game audio is, like, not actually... Wait. Do you even have game audio? You should. Let me just check here real quick. Mic check, 1-2-1-2. Audio check, 1-2-1-2. Yeah, I why am I that quiet, man? That's fucking stupid. I fucking hate streaming software sometimes. Ugh. Like, I haven't altered... Let me just try something real quick here. Right. I might be too loud now, I don't know. But... Mic check, 1-2-1-2. That's not any different, and I just turned up the microphone volume by 100%. Like... I don't get it. Yeah. Whoa, hang on a minute. Oh, I don't want to piss about with this. Give me a second here, actually. Okay. This won't sound great, but... I need the stream to be playing here for a minute. Let me know if this starts sounding better. 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 Let me know, I'm just gonna refresh my stream. Does that sound better? It's hard for me to tell. Does that sound better? It's hard for me to tell. That's that. Does that sound better? It's hard for me to tell. I can't really tell if that's better because I'm just getting a constant echo in my headphones. So, can you hear me better now? Seems like you can definitely hear the game better. Hey, what's up, Angel? I seem far away. The game is now loud. Okay. Hello, hello. Is that any better? Mic check, hello. Mic check, hello. Mic check, hello. That sounds a bit better. But I feel like is the game too loud? I was blasted by the echo. Yeah, you're not the only one. Right. So, yes, That sounds okay to me, because as soon as I press play on the stream, like, it's impossible for me to hear what you hear. That's the wrong mission. That's not Awakened Elmer, you scrub. Volume is good? Alright, cool. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, OBS, for just, you know, fucking everything up. Okay. I just went into the audio settings and changed it from percentages to decibels, and I think that was the problem. I don't know why, because I haven't altered anything, but they were all showing as percentages. So even though I'd upped it by, you know, 200%, that was only 3 decibels. 3 decibels isn't a lot. So I just changed it to decibels and put them all back to 0. Again, I did not change that. So, you know, why that was like that, I don't know. But hey, you know, that was cool. Hey, what's up, Francis York Morgan? How is that? Stop wasting my time. That'll do. What a bitch. Oh, I knew that was gonna hit me. That's too much time, honestly. Like, 25 seconds there. I'm thinking, I need, you know, she needs to be dead at 2:15, so each minion set, you're looking at 54 seconds, if we're going, you know, if we're dividing it up. Like, 54 seconds per wave, essentially. Anyone played the RE4 remake? That's the star we want. Stop that. There's no question about it, they're easier to dodge on the OG Xbox. No question. I haven't seen it, but it looks myself. You know, I did check out a bit of gameplay of it, and I must admit, it does look better than the demo. I'll say that, like, it definitely does. I'm gonna risk it. Oh, you bitch. Should've just took my ET there, but... Did I? Oh crap, thank you for that. I mean, come on, man. Come on. Is that a yellow? But yeah, I knew it. It was a fucking yellow, wasn't it? It wasn't even a blue. Wow. Oh, the as in the game is too loud, or the actual music in the game is too loud? What do you mean? Loud. Again, I really can't tell. So, it sounds all right to me though. Briefly, Zach is jealous of you. He would never admit it. You know, that's one reason that in the back of my mind that still makes me want to switch. I really want to play Deadly Premonition 2. I really, really want to play that. Or should I just watch a playthrough of it? I don't know. Is it one of those games? But that said, like, I got a real kick out of playing Deadly Premonition. It, you know, it's not a great game, you know, mechanically, but that game has some fucking charm to it that, you know, not a lot of games have. Really? Well, that was annoying. You know what? Nah, in hindsight, I could have gone the other way there, but... Fuck, well, that's annoying. I got Vernal Edge to finish first. Demo didn't make me want to run out and buy it. Wasn't chilly, by the way. No, me neither. It's funny, the RE4 demo... If they hadn't put out a demo, I'd probably be playing that. I would have bought it day one and played it. But the demo, I thought, nah, I'm good. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna wait until I can see, like, a lot more of this game. It does look good, but I don't know, man. It doesn't look good enough to, you know, the hype for me has kind of gone down for it a lot. That's a great thank you. I can see so much. That's gonna kill both. Someone just clip that camera angle, like, come on, man. What the fuck? That was literally just a close-up of the pillar. Nice. Alright, nice. My score on this is 754. The score I want to beat is 778. Which, you know, is not, like, it's not going to be crazy. It's not going to be, like, a piece of piss, but of course that happened. Did one of those just hit me twice? Did you see that? Did you see that? That was, I mean, it was a miracle I didn't get hit there, but, like, did you see the pillar, like, drop me off, you know, like, drop me off a ledge? Okay, might be able to get, I mean, my health is low here, like. I'm gonna risk this. Paid off. Right. I've never actually played Deadly Premonition, really? That's interesting. With that username, I would have, you know, I would have felt for sure you've played Deadly Premonition. For sure. Yeah, you can link clips as long as they're nothing dodgy. You should play Deadly Premonition. It's great. Of course. Oh. Man, you can just feel how slower they are. It's so weird. If anyone's got this on the original Xbox, like, fire up this mission and then go and play it on Xbox One. Like, they are noticeably easier to dodge. It's not even funny. Like, it's kind of crazy. Like, that pattern she just got there, like, I would have, like, been hesitant to dodge it on Xbox One, but on here, I was like, ah, free skate. Okay. Oh my god, that was close. I got that weird shit again. Nice. Good shit. Yeah, I know about that. It's just that's not what I've practiced. Like, I'm way more comfortable dodging them the way I dodge them. What are you doing? Okay, this is not too bad. We've got time, we've got health. Like, I shouldn't have said that, because now she's gonna just waste a shitload of time, isn't she? I do need to knock down here, though. Like, I really do. don't know if that's really worth it. I knew I shouldn't have gone for that. I mean, this is a Hail Mary, but why not? There's no way this is going to work. If I survive this, this is going to be a miracle. I knew it! I knew it. That was close, though. That was so close. Yeah, that was so close. Like, if I'd have got that, I mean, what would I... Because I had more UTs there. I would have had 30k. That still would have been pretty decent. What would that have been? I would have had 30k in UTs. And I was quicker. I had way less health, though. And I would have lost 25 on the elixir. Yeah, that still would have been about 740. So with the elixir, like, that would have been enough. So. Hey, what's up, T-Y? Right. Here we go. Yeah, I'm annoyed like, I had so many good starts on, you know, going for that CG gauntlet, and yet now, like, not really getting them. That, like, that run right there is probably the best. Although, to be fair, like, that was my fault. That second flying swallow was just pure greed. Maybe? No? Yeah, same again. Like, I would have been... I would have been like, you know, should I do that? Like, need to get some side-by-side clips here on these fireballs. How fast are they traveling on the original Xbox versus the new one? Bitch. Why does it deflect half the time? I mean, I'd say it's more than half the time. I mean, it's hard to say in terms of, like, how many times, but I would say it deflects at least, like, 60%, maybe 70% of the time. If you throw 10 at her and 3 land, like, that's pretty good. And yeah, you know, as I always say, if you figure that out, like, goddamn it, Ryu. That's gonna hit me. Yeah, if you figure that out, like, let us all know. Because, you know, yeah, so, yeah, there again, look, like, that was so much easier. That was so much easier than Xbox One. If I was a betting man, I say I would have absolutely got clipped there. Okay. Not the worst. I don't know anything. It's one of those things, you know. Also, what's up, Danger Man? It's one of those things that I think surely one day, maybe, I don't know, maybe 100 years from now, someone's gonna crack that, right? They're gonna figure it out. All of us will probably be long dead, but in 100 years, we will know the secret. That said, though, if I could change it, I wouldn't. I wouldn't. Because if your flying swallow knocked her down every time, she'd be a complete joke. She'd be so easy. But again, that was my fault. This is not good, though, because that was a total botch. Okay, I would have... Yeah, hang on a minute. Yeah, I don't think I can beat it here. I mean, I am faster, but... Yeah. There's no way. Would I prefer people watch on YouTube or Twitch? It doesn't really make a difference. Yeah, honestly, it doesn't really make a difference. Twitch is better for the chat. What's up, Brizzle, by the way? What are we doing? Twitch is better for the chat. Like, Twitch chat is just easier to read, because you can't scale YouTube's chat, unfortunately. You know when you, like, pop out a window? YouTube chat is always the same size, so it just makes it a bit trickier to read. But it doesn't really make any difference now. I mean, I guess, you know, monetarily, YouTube is actually better because, unlike Twitch, the amount of viewers you have doesn't really mean shit on Twitch in terms of, you know, your reach or, you know, people like... Or like people subscribing and that, like it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna try something here. This might work, I don't know. Of course. No point carrying on there. But yeah, it really doesn't make a difference at this point. Views on YouTube are just better overall. Twitch is kind of, I mean, I stream on Twitch, because it's what I'm used to, but, I feel like if I stopped streaming on Twitch, I feel like the vast majority of the regulars would just watch on YouTube instead. Because as I said, Twitch now, is, like, I don't stream on Twitch, you know, for the money. I just do it because it's what I'm used to. And most people, you know, like, most people know where to find me on Twitch. YouTube is still not great at like pushing streams to people. Yes, perfect. That fireball killed that purple one. So. I now get a second UT. Oh man, if that had happened twice in a row, that would have been amazing. You know, it's funny. If you had, like, a tool-assisted run of this, if you just mapped it out like that, it'd be so cool to do shit like that. Just have, like, 5 or 6 UTs in a row just kill, like, just trade with Alma's Fireball. Not the best. This is a great start, but, like, it could, like, easily die here because these cat fumes are shit. They're especially tricky when she does that. Because I need the black one. Like, I absolutely need to kill the black one. I knew that was gonna happen. Okay, I mean... You know. Maybe. Could work. That was benediction, right? Yeah. Give me that. Pretty much have to do the rest of this, like, without taking any damage until the lasers, which is... That was cheeky. Yeah, like, that's robbed me of my laser now. Like, before, I could have got hit by a laser. Not anymore. Time is good, though. Yeah, this is NG04. Yeah, this is on my original Xbox. Yeah, crap, I need... I don't want to dodge to the... Yeah, that's why I didn't want to dodge to the left. So I was like, yeah, they're going to hit me if I go that way. But I needed that money. Oh well. Amount of viewers doesn't matter on Twitch. Not really. No. It's a weird thing with Twitch lately. You know, the amount of viewers you have, I feel like, used to affect, you know, how your channel, you know, would pop up in searches and that. I've said many times, but I'm fairly certain I'm shadow banned on Twitch for some reason because, like, just no one finds my channel anymore. You know, and I don't stream, like, super regularly, but I would say I stream at least once or twice a week. You know, so it's not like there's no activity on my channel. And whenever any newcomers, like, find the channel, it's always through YouTube. Or someone telling them about it. Like, you know, I never show up on recommended or search. And when you consider that, like, how many people play NG, like, it's, you know... It's really not that many people, so, you know, there's something there's something going on there, you know what I mean? And, you know, when it comes to, you know, your, like, your... I mean, you know what, I'll take that. When it comes to, you know, like, viewers to subs, like, there's no real correlation. I don't know if anyone has any streams like that, but one I always think of as a perfect example of that. I don't know if anyone knows Orchlon, the very popular Resident Evil streamer. He averages like at least like 500 to 600 viewers pretty much constantly whenever he streams. And in one of his recent streams, he actually mentioned how many subs he has. I think he's sitting at like, I think he said like maybe 300 or like 200, like a lot less than you would think for someone who averages that many viewers a stream. Oh, you bitch. Great camera angle. Thank you. Thank you for that. No, I need my money. Okay, this is not terrible. Okay. Yeah, and there's a few others. It's funny because like not everybody, you know, is transparent with how many subs they have. But there's a few. Just when they get like sub bombs and like a total shows up, I've been surprised and I think, man, like, they only have that many. Like, that's kind of surprising. You know, if someone was averaging, you know, like several hundred viewers, I feel like, you know, I would expect them to have, you know, at least sort of a comparable percentage of that as subscribers. But I don't know, maybe people just don't want to sub on Twitch anymore since the sub split, which would make sense. That's why I had, that's why for a while I had that thing on about, you know, Patreon, because, you know, I feel like, well, like, if you wanna, like, if you wanna sub to, like, show support or whatever, like, you know, you may as well just subscribe on Patreon instead, because it's, like, that's actually way better, in terms of... Shit. What an absolute troll spawn. He's... Man. I mean, maybe... Oh, really? Yeah, okay. That essence disappeared like fucking right as I did that. This is faster, but... God, I knew it. Oh my god, he saved me! I'm dead. Yep. Oh, that fucking... That crab fiend spawning in that gleaming blade. What a dick. Yeah, you do have items, yeah, but if you want... if I want the score, you know, I'm going for, like, there's no way I can use any items. Items are worth so many points. What was I rambling about, anyway, before that mission went to shit? Viewers and that on Twitch. Yeah, so, it's why, like, if you're a small streamer now, like, if you're just starting out streaming, that was totally my fault. If you're just starting out streaming and your goal, again, this all depends on what your goal is for streaming, but if your goal for streaming is for it to be, you know, a legit side income, like a side hustle, for lack of a better word, I really don't think there's any point starting out on Twitch now. Like, you know, if you're just an average Joe, no pun intended. Because the amount of effort you're going to have to put in and the amount of time you're going to have to put in to get even, you know, maybe 10, 20 regular viewers is insane to, like, how much easier that is just streaming and doing YouTube instead. Of course that killed both. Because that's the thing with starting streaming now, you know? Even when I started, and I think in hindsight, I started way too late. I remember I did stream a little bit, like, very, very intermittently in 2012 and 2013. That's when I used to stream directly from the Elgato. I was playing Injustice. I reckon if I'd have carried on then and, you know, really committed to doing it regular, like, that would have paid off. This is terrible. But, you know, there's no guarantee. But, you know, the mistake I made was, like, not... I cannot believe that didn't hit me. I was just about to restart. I mean, I should, because... Like, we're down on time. But, yeah, it's... If someone was to ask you, you know, I'm gonna start streaming or whatever. Like, you know, what would you recommend? What would you recommend? In all seriousness, you know, all the big games, unless you are absolutely god tier good, and I mean, you know, like, I mean, I'm trying to think of like what's big now, but like in terms of competitive, like, unless you could absolutely mop the floor with like the current best people, no one's gonna notice you. Like, just a complete, you know, like message in a bottle type stream on like Call of Duty, like, you're not just gonna all of a sudden get like 10,000 viewers. Don't kill both. You know, variety streaming and that is probably a better is probably a better option. But again, you know, you've got to crack that. You've got to crack that and get an audience. That takes time. You know? And yeah, you know, you could be lucky. That's true. Like, everyone, you know, everyone can be lucky, but you know, you can't exactly plan around that. What's up, Elmar? I'm playing this on my original Xbox. That's why it doesn't look quite as great. I'm just thinking. 5k from the cat fiend. Nah, you kind of need 2 UTs at that start, really, to get, you know. Very, very good. Yeah, that's also true, Zong, yeah. That's an aspect of it, and I think that's an aspect that comes with time and experience. Most people, when they first start streaming, and especially now, because I feel like the really popular people, for the most part, I mean, you know, everyone puts on somewhat of a character when they stream. I feel like that's pretty fair to say, you know? You know, but as long as it's you, as long as it's still you, that's fine. But I feel like a lot of people now misinterpret that as, like, the people they see on Twitch and that, they all act the exact same way because they feel like they have to. That's happened, like, what, 5 times in a row now? But that's just hit both fucking minions. Look at her, what a bitch. What was I talking about? Yeah. Quick break to ramble here for a second. It's hard to really focus on this karma running this mission and talk. I saw a video yesterday, actually. It was about Giant Bomb. I didn't actually know, but Giant Bomb had a few layoffs a couple of months ago. And it's like a real skeleton crew now, Giant Bomb and GameSpot. And that video was just a dude, you know, on YouTube, like with a green screen in front of his thing on OBS. And he had a problem on OBS. And I knew the exact problem he had, but he was talking about it like most streamers do. You know, in the, oh, it's always a problem. But the thing wasn't a problem. He literally just wasn't clicking on, you know, the right scene in OBS to show his monitor. But he was acting, and he acted it up for like a solid 30 seconds. And I thought, man, literally all you have to do is click the scene for your monitor. Like, you're not having a problem here. Like, this is very fake. You're just kind of acting for the stream here. And this was someone, like, with very little views and that. So I think if you start out just kind of parroting what you think a streamer should be, could be wrong, but I feel like most people that are kind of, you know, that have been following or doing this for a while, most people are going to click off real quick when they see that. Because they can tell that's not genuine. They can tell that's not you being you. That's you being who you think you need to be a streamer, in air quotes. What's up, Ken? On a side note, did I try the remake yet? No, I tried the demo. I haven't tried the full game yet. The full game does look better, I will say. I have checked out bits and pieces of the full game, but there's a couple of things that have just kind of dragged on for a long time in terms of projects that I really want to get finished. So I'm gonna do those before. I mean, look at that. Like, okay, I fucked that up, but like, look how casual you could just walk, like, run past them almost. I totally fucked up the last bit. That was me, but I hate having stuff unfinished. Like, the main thing is the Shadow of Rome speedrun. Like, that's the main thing I've been working on off stream. It still looks decent, you know. Have you ever played the Shinobi games? As in, do you mean the originals? I mean, I've played all of the Shinobi games. Not what I would call recently. And I've only played a little bit of the PS2 one. What's up, Benzo? Welcome, by the way. I did love me some Revenge of Shinobi back then. I really did. Shitty start. Just in terms of time, that honestly looked like that should have hit me. That's gonna hit both anyway, so whatever. When I'm coming back, I might be doing another mission. Oh, nice. Have you got any mission in mind? Because the amount of people left that are, you know, gonna run mission mode for records is, you know, pretty slim. Yeah, I played the original ones a fair bit. I did. Hey, what's up, Ryu? I am suffering. Why is that? Are you trying to karma run this mission? I'm actually, low-key, a bit annoyed that I've had, maybe one good run in about an hour, and yet when I was trying that challenge, I was, fucking getting, 750 plus, back-to-back. without even really trying, I was getting some pretty insane runs. do you know what I mean? It's a bit annoying. I know. It is kind of throwing me off, I've got to admit. It is. I'm having to... I'm really having to think about how I dodge certain things because I'm thinking, okay, my roll isn't going to come out like it does on Xbox One here. That's not the problem, though. I haven't really been getting... It's going to be close. I haven't really been getting... the sequences to get this, to be honest. This is a hard mission, for sure, but if you want, if you want a really, really good score, Cat Fiends have to cooperate, the Crabs have to cooperate, Alma has to, there's only a certain amount of fireball spam you can kind of tolerate. I don't mean dodging it, I mean just in terms of time. You know, if she spends, a good 40 seconds just doing fireballs and pillars, That's 40 seconds, that's 40 seconds that you could have spent getting time. And of course, that fucking double connected. I feel like the cat fiends are kind of the worst part, though. Honestly, now that I think about it, it'd probably be more time efficient to just skip going for the cat fiend UT and just go for farming. Because, that cat fiend, getting that UT black cat fiend essence is, extremely hazardous. you can lose a hell of a lot of health going for that. Okay, at least they didn't spawn in the gleaming blade. That health is borderline as well. Really borderline. That's just enough to survive a laser, I think. Oh. Just leave it where we were. Okay, well, this has to be, perfect. No big deal. I mean, I'll take that. I'll take that. I think I'm too low to the ground. I'm pretty sure I'm going to get hit here. Yeah, I knew it. That's too low to the ground for that random UT just hitting her. If I had more health, that would have been great. So, NGT mission modes are so weird. Why do they take so long to load? I think that's just, the Xbox One. Someone's already said it. Yeah, if you're online, I think there is a video on my channel about that. It's no fucking joke, man. The load times when you're online are, five times as long. If you're playing NG2 or NGB on Xbox One, play offline. The load times are way shorter, which is kind of weird. How difficult this game be? I can still love it. I mean, yeah, it is. It's, and I still think a lot of it depends on what you're doing. If I just wanted to beat this mission, it wouldn't take me an hour. But, oh! See, look at this shit, right? Look at this. This is just time. This is all time. I kinda, you know what? I'm curious. Why did that hit her? Imagine if we find out you can just, UT farm her. Yeah, that's probably good. Whatever, we'll try again on that one. So. Aren't the leaderboards down for NG2? I don't think so. They're still up on Xbox One. They might not be... I don't know about 360, but yeah, they're still up on Xbox One, I think. I haven't actually plugged in a 360 for NG2 in quite a while, so... Anyway. We got wildly off topic there. I can't remember. We're talking about Twitch and shit. We're talking about Twitch and streaming and all that stuff. So here's a question for everybody that uses Twitch. Or, seeing as like more people watch on YouTube now. Bruh. Not my fault. While Shu plays on 360. He plays on 360? What a Chad. Man, what a beast. yeah, I can't remember what I was saying. Yeah, for those who watch on YouTube and Twitch, this is something that I think it doesn't really... You know, Twitch has definitely had some big people leave lately and move over to YouTube. Anyone got a theory on, like, why YouTube just don't seem to care all that much about streaming yet? Because if they wanted to, they could... I'm not saying they could just flip a switch and just, like, eat Twitch's lunch, but they could definitely... They could definitely flip a switch and, you know, be, like, significantly more of a threat to them. Although I think right now the biggest threat to Twitch is Twitch itself. Because it just seems to... Okay, no. I disagree with that. There's no way that should hit me. Can someone clip that? I was half looking at chat there, so... I will reserve final judgment. But I feel like I rolled... Like, more than out the way of that. I don't even know why I'm carrying on. You know, like, yeah. I think it's because YouTube is doing fine as a video platform. I mean, yeah, true. It could be that simple. It could, yeah. That's a fair point. I guess I'm thinking like tinfoil hat, man. There's got to be a reason. You know, there's got to be, you know, 8 like super overweight dudes in an office smoking cigars and snorting cocaine off, you know, hookers. Like, that's why YouTube don't do it. But yeah, maybe they're just like, yeah, we don't care. We're making money, bro. I saw recently, I don't know if it's true, but I saw an estimate, so, you know, take this with a grain of salt, but feel free to Google it, that apparently Google is making upwards of 8 figures a day from ad revenue from YouTube. Think about that for a minute. 8 figures a day from ad revenue. Like... Minimum. I mean, they didn't really, like, say, you know, what level, but I thought, man, like, imagine just making 10 million a day in anything. Like, that's kind of insane. Like, fuck, god damn it, I was reading. Okay, what am I doing? Fuck, that was a good start too. All right, let me look at this clip. Yeah, because I probably did get hit, but, you know, me half paying attention disagrees. Why is this clip not playing? Oh, there we go. Oh, yeah, that, yeah, I jumped. Yeah, you see? Yeah, I jumped. I was not paying attention there. Yeah, I jumped. That's why I got me. So, I think it's less than 10%. Yeah, I don't know. I've never, like, grinded that out, you know? I think YouTube is too focused on trying its best demonetize people. Here's a good question on that. Don't feel the need to out yourself in the chat if you don't want to, but does anyone watch any YouTube videos that are sort of dicey when it comes to ad revenue? So, no, I don't mean, you know, anything weird. I just mean, does anyone watch any gun channels, for example? Because, like, that's what I watch. I watch a lot of gun content on YouTube. And YouTube, you know, well, here's the thing. YouTube doesn't care. Like, the people at YouTube don't give a fuck. It's only the image thing that matters, you know. Advertisers don't want their ads on, you know, gun content. Because people don't like that. And I remember there was a section in a recent WAN show on Linus Tech Tips where... So they own Floatplane, for anyone that doesn't know. Floatplane is like a video streaming platform that they own. And he mentioned that he didn't name anybody, but I'd be interested who reached out to him. But he did mention they have, like, they constantly get reached out to by, like, big firearm channels from YouTube saying, oh, you know, what's float, you know, could we, like, come onto float plane? Like, you know, this seems like it'd be quite good for us because it's a much more, if anyone doesn't know what it is, think of it as, like, Patreon, but, like, a Patreon YouTube is kind of what float plane is. So what if all those people, and to be perfectly honest, like, I actually don't know of any other content that, like, is a problem on that front. Oh my days. Well, that's this run dead. I mean, yeah, like, there's just no way. Oh my god. I believe in miracles. And that cat fiend got, like, beat the fuck up on the floor, which is quite funny. Oh my god, I totally brain farted that. Damn it. That's annoying. Oh well. We'll play it out. Why not? No? Okay. I mean, yeah, you know, you don't have to, you know, you don't have to out yourself. I mean, to be fair, apart from gun channels, I don't really know what else on YouTube falls underneath that. I know movie and music stuff is kind of hit and miss in terms of ad revenue because, you know, it's kind of tricky with YouTube the way it is to, you know, do movies or music and, you know, get a lot of revenue because it's very tricky to get around their rules. And yeah, I lost my train of thought. What was I talking about? It'll come to me. Oh yeah, the WAN show where he was talking about it. So what my theory, you know, what the thing is, right? If all these people, because here's the thing with YouTube, a big reason why YouTube is the way it is because if you think about it, it doesn't really have any real competition. That's another thing. It's kind of why Twitch is the way it is, but I feel like, you know, there are definitely other streaming platforms that are, you know, kind of coming about, you might say. Whereas there's not really anything comparable to YouTube in terms of its size and reach, you know? Like, if you want to start, you know, an online video platform slash whatever, you're going to use YouTube. You just are. You just are. There's no argument there, really. You know, with... Shit, that's... If that had knocked her down, that would have been great. Not that one. Fuck. Okay, that one should be dead now. Yeah, man. I don't know. I don't know, man. Getting that black cat fiend is what's ruined a lot of runs here, so... I don't know. I might just stop going for that. Is it? Where are you hiding? Hey, what's up, DGV? I remember some platforms back then tried to compete with YouTube. Yeah. What about Vimeo and Dailymotion? Okay, genuine question. Are they still going? Like, real talk? Are they actually still a thing? So yeah, I think that's a big thing when people go on about YouTube and they're like, oh, why did they do this? Why don't they do this? It's like, When you can, like, comfortably as a company be like, well, no one's even close to fucking touching us. Yeah, I think we'll just kind of, you know, we'll just sit here and print money for a while. Like, cool. You know, we're content to do that. But there's the rub. You know, how do you set up a competitor to YouTube? And that's something where... this was also mentioned on the WAN show a while back. And they didn't elaborate on it, which annoyed me. Because I thought, man, I'd be super interested to know the figures you guys are talking about. Because they mentioned specifically, because of running Floatplane, they know, like, and I'm quoting here, they know But what a hero. Oh, man. What a hero. That Black Cat Fiend just took that combo. They knew that stuff like Twitch and YouTube weren't profitable on just ads alone. And I think, one, that's a pretty bold statement without seeing YouTube's books. And two, I thought, okay, so how much does the host it? Like, imagine, if anyone knows anything about hosting fees, like, it's definitely cheaper than it was, but, you know, if you're having, like, terabytes upon terabytes of videos uploaded every single day, you know, that's going to get expensive real quick. So, you can't just start up a YouTube competitor. Like, you know, I mean, I can't even imagine, like, the investment you would need to, you know, to pitch someone and be like, yeah, we're gonna do YouTube, but better. Like, okay, how are you gonna do that? You know? Like, it's got such a stranglehold on it for the moment. That's a bit slow, but, and yeah, like, it was annoying that they didn't go into the figures of it, because I thought, man, I would love to know, like, what's the, like, okay, we need to actually, fuck you, Sia. Trying to think about shit. I would love to know, like, the operating costs for Floatplane and that. Like, how much does it cost them to run that platform? Because on that, you know, you can't just get an account on there. Like, you have to apply for an account on there. You can't just sign up like YouTube and, you know. I mean, here's the thing, and it's kind of cool but kind of crazy in a way. You can be an absolute nobody on YouTube. As far as I know, you can make an account and just immediately start uploading, you know, like, terabytes of 4K video, you know, that you're not paying for the hosting of. And I mentioned this years ago, and I still stand by this. Look at this garbage, man. Stop doing this. I still stand by this. The second that you have to pay to use YouTube, that's too long, man. That's like 20 seconds. Come on, that's taking the piss. The second you have to pay to use YouTube, which I think is coming one day, that's when, you know, that's when the opportunity is going to be there for someone to actually come along and, like, be a legit threat to them. Because YouTube are pushing premium like fucking crazy now. Anyone use YouTube without ads? Like, does anybody use YouTube without an ad blocker? Like, God, it's fucking unbearable. I can't read that name. Why do you this game every time? I mean, I like it. Okay. Great camera, thank you. I use Adblock. I think everybody uses Adblock. Paying for YouTube is going to be crazy. Here's the thing, though, and this is where, because I know Linus has talked about this with regards to 4K when YouTube mentioned, you know, paying for 4K. There are definitely people out there that will argue, like, oh, I'm not paying for YouTube, that's ludicrous. And I think, okay, I'm like, almost at a point where I'm just going to get premium. I really am. Because premium is, like, a tenner a month. I'm not sure if you get, like, a discount if you get, like, a whole year. I need to, like, check on that. But for what you get from YouTube, like, fucking... God damn it. Okay, hey, what's up, Parson? How you doing, man? We'll play it out. Yeah, for what you actually get from YouTube, is pretty fucking amazing. As a, like, YouTube as a resource, I actually feel is genuinely underrated as hell. Like, think about what it is. Like, you have virtually any problem, you can at least get a baseline of help via YouTube for free. And, you know, it, like, there is a conversation with regards to, well, you know, is it free because, you know, you need a PC, or, you know, you need something to view it on. But, like, that's a different conversation, I feel like. You know, most people are going to have the means to view YouTube. Yeah, I'm really second guessing this Cat Fiend, because this is just killing too many runs. So for me, if tomorrow they flick to Switch, and I've said this before too, if they flick to Switch tomorrow, and just said, right, to even have a YouTube account and watch YouTube, it's a fiver a month, you know, or five, whatever the equivalent of a fiver is where you live. You know, I'd just pay it. I would just pay it and be like, yeah, cool, fine, fiver a month, whatever. I only don't pay for it now, and I feel like a lot of people are like this. They're just not honest about it, to be perfectly blunt. I think the reason most people don't pay for it, for like Adblock and that, is because Adblock is just free and super easy to install. Like, it takes zero effort to install an Adblock and not watch ads on YouTube. You know? Let's be real. It takes zero effort to do that. How long does it take? 10 seconds to get an Adblock installed? And your experience of using YouTube is improved, you know, 100-fold for not having to. Look at this camera. Look at that. Like, are you taking the piss? They're not going well, honestly. I've only had probably 2 decent runs so far, and yet it's annoying because when I was doing this on going for that 700k back to back, I was just getting like 750s, like fucking. Like 3-4 times in a row. This is annoying. YouTube would destroy any competition they crossed. I agree on that, though. I agree. Even if YouTube flipped their switch tomorrow and said, right, we're whipping out our wood. If you want to see our wood, you've got to pay us money, bro. You know, I still feel that they would do.
I'm not a pervert!
It's one of those things where I think, you know, on Twitter, people would be like, no, I'm not paying freedom, blah, 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 blah. And then the next day, every single one of those people would have YouTube Premium. Like, nobody would actually stick to their guns regarding that. You know, it'd be like Left 4 Dead 2 and Modern Warfare 2 all over again. You know, I'm not buying that. And then, you know, the next day, like, every single person on the boycott is buying his plan. And that was greedy. She's wasting a lot of time. Hey, what's up, Ragnar? Thank you for the raid, man. What's up? Like that one Twitch click, $5 a month. But yeah, what was I saying? Let's have a quick tea break. We have tea here. Some quick tea break and just chat for a minute. So yeah, if they did that, I think most people would pay. I really do. But I think that's not, you know, the real issue to Adblock is just how easy it is to get it up and running, you know. If it was complicated, you know, most people. So as an example, someone just mentioned jailbreaking a tablet, actually. I don't do that. Like, on my phone and my tablet, I don't have an ad blocker or anything, because I just can't be arsed, you know. My phone and tablet are things I use frequently enough to where, like, I don't want any bullshit on them. I was like, no, I just want to use these and have no, I don't want to worry about anything. You know, my PC is a different story. You know, my PC is like my car, you know, that's like hot rodded and shit. I want my PC custom. I ain't having no ads on PC. And also, does anyone else think this is more the problem, right? I don't think ads themselves are the problem. It's not the existence of the adverts that's annoying. It's the fact that 99.9% of adverts you see on YouTube make you want to gouge out your own brain through your eyes and eat it. I think that is, and if anything, that's an understatement. I feel like that's the bigger issue. It's the fact that ads are just fucking insufferably bad these days. And if anyone's seen the film Event Horizon, if they remade that, it would just be people stuck on the Event Horizon, like with their head clamped in front of a monitor that was just nothing but YouTube ads 24/7. That's what it would be. That's Event Horizon 2. That's the sequel. Like, genuinely, that's the bigger problem. Is that the... And Twitch is the same, too. Like, just, you know, like, adverts in general are just... God, they're fucking hard to sit through these days. They're so cringe. Shit. I absolutely would have got hit there on the Xbox One. I would bet money on... I just jumped into a wall. Like, into an invisible wall. And those fireballs missed me. Like, I actually want to do that. Look at that. Look at that. There is no fucking way they wouldn't have hit me on Xbox One. I really want to. I'm trying to think of ways. 40 fucking seconds. I want to try and think of a way I could actually compare these, but I don't think the recording would be, you know, equivalent. What's up, Mark? Adverts are like the cancer of the... They really are, yeah. Remember when adverts used to be funny? Remember when adverts used to be, you know, relatively smart? And, you know, you could appreciate them and be like, oh, yeah. Nowadays, adverts is just some fucking dude yelling at you to buy something. It's all they are. You know? That's why, like, do you bake in sponsor ads on videos? Like, do they bother people? You know when, like a creator has a sponsor? And, you know, it's like, this video is brought to you by... And then, you know, it's like a 20, 30 second advert for, like, whatever they're... Like, recent... Like, they never used to bother me. Recently, like, I feel like they have been getting... Like, they've been getting kind of crazy with how long they are. So, like, some of them are pushing a minute long. And I think, dude, like... Come on. Like, this is... Like, I just skip them now. You know how YouTube, like, breaks up videos and it tells you? It tells you, like, what portion of the video is the sponsor. So you can just fast forward, like, right through it. Like, that's what I do every time. Like, I don't care what your sponsor is. I'm... Nice. Okay, shut up. What's up, Ligma? That fucking cat fiend. Okay, that was good. Got celerity on him. Okay. We'll talk about that in a second. Someone remind me what we were talking about, but yeah. This is a run. This is a run right here. Alright. 30-second unskippable ads. Man. Yeah, you see, I don't remember that, though, because, say, I've always had an ad block. And also, like, you know when websites that you go to, and they're like, oh, it looks like you're using an ad block. And you're like, yeah, damn right I am. Like, have you tried using the internet without one? It's fucking unbearable. It's like, bro. Okay, hopefully I won't get unlucky here. Nice. Alright. Not great. This music's so sick, man. Where's my other money? Give me that. Okay, pray for me, people. Come on. That hurt. Oh! I mean, I could have played that safer, but no guarantee I would have got it. Like, man, I fucking had it there, though, if I'd have got that. Ads in medieval times were just some dude yelling at you, we've gone... You know, that's a really good way of putting it, actually. Yeah? That is a really good way of putting it. We have. Like, and that's what... That's why sponsorship stuff, that's why, like, the sponsor ads, like, bug me now more than they used to, because... Like, some people are just straight up hawking shit, man. Can we be real? Like, some people are just selling you fucking junk. Or, you know, something that you just... You absolutely do not fucking need. Like, you know what one really pisses me off lately? And it goes in, like, fits and bursts of being popular. Waste too much time. Is the Ridge Wallet. What's up, Mole, by the way? I don't remember if I said hello earlier. I didn't. I wasn't ignoring you. Yeah, like, that really annoys me. Like, has anyone actually looked at how much they cost? Those Ridge Wallets? Like, it is, I mean, you know, it's a free country, man. You spend your money on what you want, but I saw one of them. First time I saw one, actually, was at the airport when I went to America last month. Well, no, this month. Yeah, I actually saw one. A dude had one at the airport. And the whole point of that thing, like, the whole fucking shtick, like, the whole selling point of that Ridge wallet is that it's quicker and, like, faster than a normal wallet, right? Because you've got all your cards in there, right? This dude, he gets out his Ridge wallet. He has to take out every single card he's got to get to his credit card, because his credit card is in the middle. If people don't know what a Ridge wallet is, it's just like a tiny little card wallet that's made of, like, I mean, you can get it in all sorts of materials, but you just basically stack up all your cards on top of each other. And I thought, man, like, what a bill of goods. You know, like, the whole point is that it's supposed to be easier. It's like this dude just had to get out every single card to get, like, the card he wanted. Can we talk about that real quick, though? Like, seriously? Man, they are easier to dodge. That, like, cancelled my UT, which came out, by the way, which should have hit that imp, and not only did I not get any points or any money, I got the, you know, the phantom platform thing, and I got fucking hit. Like, god damn it. Never seen the ad, first time hearing it. It's on Linus Tech Tips, has adverts for the Ridge wallet quite a bit. Which, now that I think about it, I don't think I've seen anyone who works there actually use. So take that for what you will. But yeah, those things are like north of $70 for one of them. And I don't know, man. $70 for a wallet? Like, you can go to a bespoke leather shop, and you could probably get one. You could get, like, a really fucking, like, sexy wallet, you know? Made for less than that. And I don't know, man. The whole, you know, everything being, like, super industrial these days, you know? Like, my wallet's made of metal. I think, great. Like, no one cares. You know, I don't know. Maybe that's just me. I don't think that's cool or whatever. Yeah, that's not gonna work, is it? Yep. We're all billionaires. We have countless cards we can choose to use. We need those wallets now. I mean, yeah, also that, but, like, how many cards do people really have? You know? How many do they really have? I mean, you think you have what? Like, credit card? Maybe, like, credit card, driver's license? I mean, I have, like, funny, the leather wallet example. I was at Camden Market years ago. And I got like a card wallet from this, like, little leather store at a market. It was a tenner. Like, principle is exactly the same as the Ridge wallet, and yet it was a tenner, and it's way better. Like, got just enough spaces for all the cards. I only use, like, two cards in my driver's license, so I don't really need a whole lot. Like, how many cards you got on? Thing is, if Ridge Wallet was to offer you a sponsorship, here's the thing about that, York. I have had a couple of sponsorship offers lately. They've been trash, so I've not bothered with them. But, yeah, I have asked myself that question. Because at the end of the day, man, what's up, Shin? You know, all that stuff, like, it's shitty, but I have to admit, my stance on it has altered over the years, because YouTube and this whole content thing has just become a different beast, you know? Posting videos to YouTube is not what it was 10 years ago. It's not even what it was 5 years ago. So if Ridge Wallet were like, hey, here's, you know, $2,000 a month to, you know, put this little thing in your video, Like, you interested? I'd think, huh. Like, you know. $2,000 a month is, I mean, I don't know that's how much they pay. I have no idea what the sponsorship deals offer. I think, you know, that's, you know, that's not like an insignificant chunk of change every month. Really. This is dead. Fucking cat fiends, man. But yeah, you know, there's definitely sponsorships that I would be super adverse to. So, FYI, the ones that I've had offered, one of them has been Raid Shadow Legends, no surprise. I imagine everyone on the face of the planet has probably been offered a Raid Shadow Legends sponsorship. And here's the thing about them, right? And I did mention this when I first started getting them. In terms of a business decision, those raid deals are pretty good. Full disclosure, I considered it briefly. I thought, damn, that's like not a bad offer, all things considered. But I thought, nah, it's too much work, and I don't want, like, as I said, the biggest thing for me is the baked in ads. I never want to do baked in ads, on a video, because I, for one, like, fucking hate them, and I just think they kill the, you know, the pacing of a video. Like, I hate that. So, you know, that's just me. So I wouldn't do that. But man, like, that raid one, it was like several hundred a month for, you know, very little effort on my part. Like, very, like, all I'd have to have done was put in, you know, like, the 30, 40 second, you know, section, put a link in the description, and that was it. And, you know, play the game for, I don't know, I can't remember what it was, like, a few hours. Like, that was it. And I'm like, man, that's not bad, actually. But, seeing that, yeah, everyone. You know what's funny about the raid sponsorships, though? Has anyone noticed that they're a little bit in on the joke with regards to them being such a meme sponsor now? Like, some people actively take the piss out of Raid Shadow Legends in their sponsorships. I think, well, at least they've got a sense of humor about it, you know? Which, to be fair, that's totally what I'd do. Yeah. I would be like a massive troll on my sponsorship deals. Great camera angle. Thank you for that. Alright, that's like the 100th time in a row that's killed both of them. You know, I'm getting fed up with this shit. We're just gonna play this, and then that's it, whatever. Yeah, it's really strange, the whole... It's kind of weird, like, how different YouTube and that is now. With regards to, you know, if you, Man, here's... On that note, right, I fell down a bit of a rabbit hole yesterday. Has anyone seen that there are extensions and plugins you can get for your browser that show you that sick. They show you what tags a video has. Has anyone noticed them? I heard about them on a stream a while back and thought, really? That's a thing? Nice. Fuck off. Of course. What? Oh my god. Ryu. Please. What the hell was that garbage? Alright, that's GG's. This is not gonna happen. Today is evidently not the day for this. We'll try again tomorrow. Raid Shadow Legends understands that almost any publicity... Yeah, true. Yep. Very good point. Very good point. I need to ask, do you ever get sweaty by eating hot food? No, I don't, actually. My tolerance for spicy food's pretty good. I do like spicy food, I do. I do like a bit of spice in my food. On that note, I tried, everyone probably knows of hot ones, but you know the Last Dab sauce? Jason Wavell, he had some of that, and I tried a bit of it. I was a bit hesitant at first, because it was first thing in the morning. It was breakfast, and I thought, like, I don't want to try this and get, like, absolutely fucked for the rest of the day. But, you know, we did it. And I was actually surprised. It was really nice. It was definitely hot. Like, it does definitely have a kick. but it has got real flavor. It's not just, you know, blow your head off the fires of hell, you know, and you immediately shit yourself. Do you know what I mean? It's actually got some nice flavor to it. So I was surprised at that. But yeah. The whole YouTube game now is weird. No one's mentioned it, but I will. Because, you know, I'm conscious of it. But since I've come back, I've been, like, super lazy with regards to streaming and YouTube. Even though, you know, I'm still putting quite a fair few things out. Now that I've moved back here, and I also got a pretty decent pay rise last year, like at the end of the year. The money that I used to get from, like, Twitch and YouTube is of, like, a lot less importance now. It's still nice, but I was thinking about kind of overhauling Patreon with that regard. Because if I was to stop streaming and just go back to doing YouTube videos, no one would really know what to expect, and, like, the interaction would be a lot less than it is now. So yeah, I was really mulling that over the other day. Because it's weird. Like, how many people, out of curiosity, how many people are subscribed to more than 5 Twitch channels or YouTube channels? Like, either or, it doesn't really matter. You know, if you say subscribe to, like, 3 Twitch and 2 YouTube, like, you know, I'd count that as 5. You know what I mean? I'm curious. Because it's one of those things that, you know, it's almost expected now from creators. Well, some. You know, you can. It's not uncommon to see, you know, brand new channels, you know, kind of play that game. I mean, like, you know, like, comment, subscribe, join, you know, join, make sure you're a member on YouTube, you know, like, be a subscriber on Twitch and all that. And I think, you know, let's say you have even half a dozen creators that you follow regularly, you know, and that's a fiver a month to all of them, you know. Like, that mounts up. Like, you know, a fiver a month, like, mounts up pretty quickly. You know? Before the Twitch temp ban, I had, like, 20 plus subscriptions. Nowadays, barely 4. Fair enough. Man, 20? I mean, yeah, I mean, that's over 100 a month. That's, to most people, like, you know, you'd notice 100 a month going. YouTube 0. Don't use YouTube account to watch stuff. Yeah, me neither. I'm not a member of anyone's YouTube channel. Because, and here's the thing with that too, like, maybe this is a grandfathered problem or mindset, I don't know. I mean paid subscriptions. How many YouTube members, like, are you on, like, how many Twitch subscriptions do you have that, you know, where you're actually paying? The mere fact that you're, like, choosing to put it out on YouTube, you have to understand that the vast majority of people are going to consume it for free. Because they can. And it's the same argument with, like, you know, the argument that we talked about a minute ago with Adblock, you know. If the barrier to circumvention is practically zero, 99% of people are going to do it. And I think that's just the way it is. And I don't think that mentality is ever going to change. Because I've heard people kind of use that, like argue against that with, like, oh, that's, like, just an outdated mentality of the internet. I think, nah, man. That's just how most people are. If the vast majority of people can get something for free with very little opposition, they will. Yeah, and also, very little opposition and zero consequence. It's not like the big boss man comes knocking on your door if you use Adblock for too long. There's no downside to using it, really. Well, you know, for you. So. But, you know, views are still important, though. That's the thing. Especially if you're talking YouTube. If I was pulling in, like, 2 million views a month, but I didn't have any members, I wouldn't really complain. Okay, I was going to raid Gala, but she's just gone off. That's annoying, because I haven't managed to catch her stream in ages, because, God, then again, isn't it, like, 2 a.m. there right now? I'm only a paid member of one YouTube channel, and that's it. No paid Twitch channels. Yeah, there you go. And there are some that I think there's a couple of cooking channels that I watch regularly, and I think, man, you know, I am getting a lot of value out of these videos, but you know, maybe that's just, you know, being older. I don't know. If people that are, it'd be really interesting to ask that question to, you know, a group of like final year students in school, you know, that are like 16. That'd be really, because, you know, they've grown up with YouTube and Twitch and just like social media presence being associated with a living, you know. For the first, what, decade of YouTube, it was just something you did because, you know, it was fun. It's fun to make videos. That's a relatively recent thing. So it's really hard to say. It's fascinating to watch it all unfold, though. I will say that. It really is. Oh, by the way, Chapter 3 of Kel's Run is up, if no one's seen it. Of course, I watched it straight away. There's some good shit. I'm too old. that's funny. It's amazing how, I don't know, is it NG or is it just games in general? There was just a comment on that Alma combo thing I put up. And it was, oh, this is really good, but I'm too set in my ways, so I can't use it. And I think, man, there are definitely examples of that, but they're very few for me. Like, if I find something that's, you know, like, more optimal in a game, like, I have to use it. I can't. There are examples, for sure, of where I don't do that. Like, RE4's one. I don't use Dipman, even though, like, it's broken as fuck, but I don't know, I just don't. It's a channel I've been watching for years, and I interact with that YouTube and his community constantly. Alright, yeah, fair enough. But, yeah, I don't know. I'll be very interested. Not that I'm wishing time away, but I am really curious where all this stuff is going to be, even by the time I'm, say, 40. You know, I think right now it's fairly safe to say we're in the boom of it, you know? We're definitely in the boom of, you know, everyone kind of having their platform and being able to make money in that. I mean, even if it's not a lot of money, you know, I mean, just as a comparison, right? We're on the OG Xbox here. Where's my saves? I think they're at the bottom, right? No? Are they at the top? Here we are. Here's all my karma runs. Here's all my final karma runs, look. Look at that, man. 148 hours on that. That's my Master Ninja run. Fucking hell. If at the age I was at, I was earning like a couple of hundred a month for making these videos, dude, I would, like, as like 15, 16, earning that amount of money from fucking YouTube would have been amazing. Like, that would have been fucking insane. You know, now everyone starts YouTube and they're like, I'm going to make fucking millions, bro. It's like, nah, you're probably not, actually. You're probably going to do it for 6 months and then quit. You know? Probably not even 6 months. But yeah, so here's some history for you, man. You can really see the escalation of karma runs here, can't you? So, FYI, that was my... I mean, it wasn't my first normal run, but it was the run that, you know, it was the last normal run I did, you know, seriously for the top 10. 16 hours total for a karma run. Which I then beat. I then beat that when I did that no reset run with Al, which is pretty hilarious. So that shows you, like, how far it went in a span of time. My next run was Ninja Dog. That's where I broke 18 million, and that was the first 18 million run, and that was the world record at the time. 30 hours, you know, getting up there a little bit. Then it was hard, 20, because I was half labbing and checking some stuff. Then very hard, 31 hours, and that was 22.3. That was world record for a very long time. And then here's the fucking... the fillet steak with... just a side order of caviar. 150 hours. And that does not factor in, you know, time spent sort of planning stuff out in my head and you know, like labbing fights and that, you know. What's up, Maxi? I don't know if you mentioned it yet, but wondering if the RE4 remake is on the schedule. I've been watching RE4 and so I'm going to wait to watch you play it first. Oh, nice. I am definitely going to play it. I don't know how soon, though. It's probably not going to be... it's probably not going to be within the next month, I can say, unless, you know, I start looking at some more video and it just looks absolutely, you know, sexy as fuck. But yeah, it's probably not going to be before May. And I don't think it'll be any time before May, to be honest, because I just, there's a couple of other really big things I want to get done before I start doing that. And then once those things are done, those things, by the way, are Shadow of Rome speedrun and PN3 stuff. When those things are done, I don't really have anything in mind. You know, so I'm probably just going to get back to, you know, playing some games that I've missed over the last couple of years. The old backlog. I desperately hope OnlyFans dies by the time my daughter is old enough to understand what it is. Man, that touches... okay, so that touches on something relatively close to home, right? So I have a niece... for anyone that wasn't aware. What's up, church? And I, too, have worried about that. I mean, you know, my brother, obviously, is probably... here's the thing, right? I don't know. And it's something I've kind of had half a mind to ask him. But it's kind of a tricky... you know, it's a delicate subject, for sure. My brother is definitely not as plugged in when it comes to, you know, the internet and that shit. Or internet culture, you might say. As I am. So he might not even know what it is. Like, he genuinely might have no idea that site exists. And I've thought about that, too. I've thought about, man, you know... I really hope that... because, I mean, once you open that door, there's no fucking closing it, man. You know? That's, you know, there's already horror stories out there, you know, of like, 18-year-old girls... trying OnlyFans and it not going well, and then, you know, it's all out there. It's like, it is, and I don't know, I mean, is that, can you, you know, I'm just Google that, I'm curious. It's all about the money at the end of the day, isn't it? If they're making money, it's probably not going to go anywhere anytime soon. Here we are. Between 2020 and 2021, OnlyFans revenue increased by 220%. Revenue was $1.2 billion in 2021.
Damn.
So, I would argue it's probably not going anywhere anytime soon. Man. Although, I will say though, right? It seems like over the last year, maybe? Year or so? Because here's the thing, OnlyFans, I think for most people, still has the connotation of it basically just being a porn site, you know? And I feel like less so these days, you know? It's definitely still got that kind of reputation, but it's not, you know, dialed to 11 the way it used to be. So, you know, I don't know. Let's see. I actually know a girl in real life who has an OnlyFans. All her fans or people who know her. Yeah, you see, that's kind of weird, right? I don't know. Does anyone else think that's kind of weird? I'm going to change the stream, by the way, because I'm not going to play anymore, because I'm just fed up with this shit right now. We're going to go to just chatting here. There we go. Yeah. There we go. Anyone else find the menu music on NGE just... I really like the menu music. Like, this could play in a waiting room. I dig it. Yeah, so was it... yeah. Or, yeah, so here's the thing, right? Does anyone on here use Twitter or Instagram? It's funny how they're like the old men fucking social media platforms, right? It's like, oh, you use Twitter, like you fucking dinosaur, or like you use OnlyFans, what a boomer. But anyway, I digress. I haven't been on Twitter for a long time now. But when I was on it, it was really jarring to find people that you knew in real life. You know, sometimes when it would say, oh, like, so-and-so contact is on Twitter. And I'd have a look, you know, I'd have a quick look at there, and I think, oh, wow, like, you're a very, very different person on Twitter. Like, you're a different beast on Twitter, man. It's kind of weird, you know? For better or for worst, for better or worse, like, I'm 95% the person I am on stream, like, off stream, you know? There's just certain things I don't bring up on stream because it's just not smart to do so, you know? But yeah, you know, for the most part, I'm just me. I'm not a completely different person online. And some people really are, and it's just, it's jarring, you know? So that, you know, having an OnlyFans and having people that know you in real life, like, here's another thing. Most people that I know in real life, like, do not watch my stream, ever. They just don't watch it. And I think, yeah, you know, I can kind of understand that, because I probably wouldn't either, you know? If my friends, like, if, you know, if a friend of mine started streaming, it'd be kind of weird. Like, I'd feel, like, strangely voyeuristic for watching them. Like, I don't know, man. It's weird, even though, like, humans are very voyeuristic anyway, but, you know. NGB music is great. Yeah, it is. Comfy lobby music. Yeah, like, this could play in a lift and you'd feel cool. Most kids use Insta for dating now. It's weird. I say kids, I mean young adults, I guess. Yeah, that's true, man. I overheard a conversation like that on... it was at the gym, actually. Of people just... like, DMing someone on Instagram. And saying, like, hey, like, do you want to do something? Like, that would... if that happened to me... I mean, let's be real. It depends on how hot she was. But, you know, if Gal Gadot dropped into my DMs, I'd be like, yeah, where do you want to go for dinner? Like, I would just immediately block that person, because I'd think, no, that's definitely a bot, that's a scam, that there's no way that's a real person, you know what I mean? And I think to be aware, like, I think that is just a byproduct of my age and growing up, you know? If a total random person on the internet, like, contacts you and it's like, hey, let's do something in real life, you're like, no, get the fuck out of here. You know? Whereas, you know, now, like, meeting people, like, online and through dating apps and that, like, super common. It's super common. It's how most people probably, you know, shoot their shot, as the saying goes. You know? It's weird. Like, to me, that's super strange. Like, if I was to ask anybody out, like, I'd do it face-to-face. Or at the bare minimum... like, on the, like, even doing it over the phone, I wouldn't like, but if there was no other option, I'd do that. But I think, to me, like, you know, you ask someone that, like, that's face-to-face, you know? You don't do that in a text. I don't know, man. Again, maybe I'm just not it anymore. It's weird to know you're... Yeah. Great minds. Yeah, that's a realization that I think is really jarring, and I think it happens to a lot of people, and I feel like it might be something to do with setting the world to rights here, man. But I think it might have something to do with why over the last decade there's been a lot more awareness in sort of like mental health issues and insecurities, because for the first time ever, you have had a generation of people, and I'm mainly talking about people my age, like people my age and maybe a few years older, that have seen an insane leap in terms of, you know, culture shift, technology shift, you know, the world now compared to when I was a kid, and I'm talking, you know, school age, is completely different. And that's always going to be the case, but And maybe this is just a case of, you know, kind of self-absorption or something, I don't know. But I don't feel like someone who grew up in, like, the 50s versus the 60s is that different. Whereas if you grew up, you know, in the 90s versus even the 2000s versus the 2000s to the 2010s, it's mad different. It's mad different. A kid that grew up in the 2000s would remember, you know, cassette tapes and VHS and MP3 players. A kid that grew up in the 2010s is not gonna know any of that shit. That's completely, like, that's old ass shit. Yeah, that's just one example. So maybe that's why there is kind of that disconnect of people getting to, you know, their 30s and 40s and looking at the world and thinking, man, you know, this is not the world I grew up in. This is, it's, you know, it's kind of jarring, honestly. Japanese girls are super into this. I live in Japan. They prefer being contacted through Insta. Really? Man, I need to find some Japanese girls on Instagram. I mean, cool. I didn't know that. I'm a young adult. People think I'm weird because I don't use Instagram or Twitter. Yeah? I can imagine they do. I do have an Instagram, but it genuinely is just for me. Because I realized a couple of years ago that there's almost zero pictures of me in existence. Like, see, I fucking hate photos. I really do. I've always been camera shy. I really hate being on camera. And I have a special loathing for photos. Like, I fucking hate pictures. But in recent years, you know, again, you get a little bit older, you realize the importance of photos, you know? Like, photos are important, man. They, you know, it sounds, like, totally cliche to say it, but, like, they are a moment in time. Like, you immortalize that moment when you take a photo. So I've made a much more conscious effort to, like, take pictures. And that's why I have my Instagram, because it's, like, just for me. It's a way for me to, like, record moments just for me, you know. I don't care about, like, people following me or whatever, you know. I think that's important. The world is changing just faster and faster. Yeah, it is. 100%. Even 2013 seems crazy compared to now. It does in some ways. Yeah, but in some, I feel like in some, I think we've actually regressed, to be honest. But yeah, it definitely does in some ways, you know. Same, literally since birth, I looked angry at the photographer. Yeah, me too. Like, I just, and also, I think, you know, some people just have really photogenic faces. You know what I mean? I don't. Some people just have a great smile. I don't. So I either look angry, or I look, you know that bit in Terminator 2 that was cut, that's in the extended version, when they go up to some, I think it's a, like, some food counter or something. I can't remember what it is. I could be getting that totally wrong. But John says to him, he says, oh, you know, you need to start doing a few other things to seem more like a normal person. And he says, oh, like what? And he says, oh, you know, smile, for example. And he says, what's a smile? Like, what does that even mean? And he says, oh, well, you know, look at that guy over there. He's smiling. And he just mimics, like, the facial. He, you know, the machine just breaks it down to, like, the pure mechanics of smiling. I feel like that's what my smile looks like, which is why, like, I very rarely smile in photos, because I think it's just, it's fucking awful. It's an awful smile. So, a JTU coming an old man. But on that note, to go back on everything I just said, on that note, right, Church, I was watching a Q&A with a YouTuber that I watch quite frequently. Because this is something that does, like, grind. This is something that ironically makes me sound like an old man. The idea that once you hit 30, you're old is fucking dumb as a condom with holes in it. It's so stupid that, you know, people have got it in their head that once they're 30, like, that's it. They might as well get a fucking Zimmer frame and pick out their coffin. That is the craziest thing I've ever heard. And it genuinely seems to be, like, so common these days. And I think, you, like, at 30, you could live another 60 years. You could live twice as long as you have lived. And let's be real, like, when you're a kid, that doesn't really count. Because you can't, you know, living as an adult is way different than living as a kid, you know? Your first 15 years are vastly different to the second 15. You know? And that just kills me these days, man. When, like, I know people that have turned 30 recently, and, you know, they're like, oh, but, you know, like, I'm not where I want to be in life. And I think, you're fucking 30, not 50. And even 50, man. Like, again, you could live to be 90. Like, you got another 40 years, man. What's up? It's me. I'm doing good, man. We'll be chilling. You know what? I'm going to do this real quick, just so I have it on video. Let's go through my mission mode scores real quick, just so I have them. Man, I need to redo that. Because every now and then I still get paranoid that this Xbox is going to die. And I hope, you know, I don't want that to ever happen, but, you know, it might. I can have my scores immortalized. Man, I didn't farm the clone missions very much. I'm not going to go for 56 mil. Just putting that out there. Yeah, and I could definitely get quite a bit more out of Eternal Legend. People that think that, ironically, will come to that realization when they reach it themselves. Yeah, they will. I just think that, you know, it's going to... That's going to be kind of weird, because when I was, you know, in my early 20s, like, I didn't have that mentality at all, you know. And that's something that, funnily enough, you know, in recent years, like especially the last couple, my 20s were pretty fucking good, man. Like, overall, I really did. I won't say I made the most of them, because obviously, if I could go back and do them again, I'd do things differently. But you know, I had a pretty good crack during my 20s. I really did. And I feel like now people. It feels like, at least, you know, people are in such a hurry to do shit that they end up doing less. You know that saying, like, life can pass you by while you're making plans for it, you know? I think there's a lot of wisdom in that quote. I think, you know, don't get too caught up in planning shit. You know, plan less, do more, maybe. But, you know, there's a certain, you know, planning is good, you know, but there's a certain amount of, you know, you gotta just kind of just do it. Just do shit. You never know. Anyway, that's gonna do it for me, guys. No one's on, unfortunately. Everyone's playing RE4. Like, legit, everyone is playing RE4. Bunch of sheep. So, anyway, I'll catch you guys later. I might be back later on tonight, if not tomorrow. So yeah, thanks for chilling. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will see you again soon. Peace.